Joining me now, the president of Media Matters, Angelo Carasone. Angelo, you say you're not leading this campaign. I read your statement, but that he's essentially running a campaign against himself. I'm paraphrasing. But you're certainly goosing it along, right?
I am trying to provide information about Sean Hannity to people that have to make business decisions about their relationship with Sean Hannity. And I think that, you know, if there was nothing objectionable or concerning to both the businesses as well as to Sean Hannity, I don't think you would have seen the reaction from him or the advertisers that you've seen.
I'm referencing the posting of a list of his advertisers. We can put that up on the screen.
Yeah.
I guess my question is, well, why not run a campaign that says, hey, what he's saying is offensive? Turn him off instead of trying to exert leverage on the advertisers, because, and you and I had this conversation before relative to Bill O'Reilly, to me, it gets to the realm of censorship. Why can't you reach the audience instead?
I don't think that it's censorship if a company doesn't want to associate with or give money to a personality. I'm not saying that Sean Hannity shouldn't be able to say the things he says. I'm just saying that that businesses should have some intentionality behind their advertising. One thing that happened during the Bill O'Reilly, you know, sort of flare up was that it was very clear that advertisers weren't being intentional about where they putting their money. And so what we've been doing is working with media buyers to say, look, just ask yourself the question, do I know where I'm advertising and is it intentional? And if the answer is yes, fine, then they'll have to deal with the volatility or the consequences if that's who they choose to associate themselves with. But if the answer is no, I don't know that, then at least inform yourself and then see if you're comfortable with your decision. And that's sort of where we're at now.
But it kind of presupposes that they don't know what they're buying, right? I would think that if I'm one of those advertisers, I've investigated the product and I've made some value judgment. That is, until Media Matters leans on me.
We agree. They actually don't know what they're buying. That's been the exact issue, and that's why you see the reaction that you see. That's why a campaign or attacking the advertisers or criticizing them or pressuring them to, you know, leave Sean Hannity was not necessary, because they actually don't know. Many of them do not know that their ads are running on programs like Sean Hannity, and to the extent that they even become aware of that, they don't really know the depth of, say, the volatility or riskiness associated with Sean Hannity's programming. They might think of him as just another conservative talker, and that they don't fully recognize just how volatile he actually is. I mean, he's at war with both Fox News right now and his own advertisers that are still on the program. The guy is incredibly volatile and a bad bet.
I want to ask you, which of two headlines is more accurate? Put them up on the screen. Both are from yesterday. One from the New York Times, which says, in controversy, Hannity isn't seeing advertisers' exodus that O'Reilly did. The LA Times, Stephen Battaglio, Sean Hannity goes on vacation as some advertisers drop out of his show. What's the deal, according to Media Matters? Are advertisers fleeing Hannity like they did O'Reilly?
So I think both of those headlines are accurate. No, advertisers are not leaving Bill O'Reilly's, Sean Hannity's program at the speed at which they were leaving Sean Hannity. That's just the case. And that's because there actually isn't a massive campaign here. It's literally just asking the question. All we've done is hold up a mirror. However, it is true. Advertisers are leaving Sean Hannity's program. The moment that many have become made aware of that, they have made the decision that that is not what they want to be associated with. And in fact, one company, Crown Plaza, was so upset that their ads were running on the first place that they fired their media buyer. And I think it's a lesson to all media buyers out there that if you're going to place ads, just do it intentionally. That's all I'm saying here, is just have some intentionality behind your advertising strategy.
Final question. Has it occurred to you that you may create yet another conservative behemoth? Because if you're successful in dislodging Hannity, maybe he pals up with O'Reilly and heads over to, say, Newsmax.
That very calculus reassures the idea that I am not out there just trying to drive these people away or have censorship or shut them down. All I want is some intentionality behind where people put their money. And I do think that, frankly, I think the media buyers are grateful for what we're doing right now, because what we're doing is educating them and informing them about a risky business association that they have right now. And they have a chance to avoid the next controversy, because what Sean Hannity did with Seth Rich's story, resurrecting this old conspiracy from last summer and hurting these people's families, this is not a one-off. This is part of his business model. And it is a bad business model. And many of the companies that are paying for that business model model don't even know it. I'm not trying to shut them down, but I just think that if you should have some intentionality in this marketplace. And I think Sean Hannity leading a campaign to pressure advertisers and stoke it, as he's been doing, and launching this "We Go If He Goes" boycott that he started, is not going to help matters at all, and is only going to further antagonize and inflame the situation. And lastly, reinforces and proves the point that Sean Hannity is volatile and bad business.
Angela.